Students, in today's video, we are going to learn about George Alton Mayo, his contribution with special emphasis on Hawthorne's experiment. George Alton Mayo was an Australian who ended up as noticeably one of the best known administration scholar. After his test takes a shot at workers in inspiration in the 1920s and 1930s. Mayo's reputation as a management guru rests on the Hawthorne's experiment, which he conducted from 1927 to 1932 at the Western Electric Hawthorne's work in Chicago. He was an Australian psychologist, sociologist, and organizational theorist. He lectured at University of Queensland before moving to the University of Pennsylvania. He spent most of his career at Harvard Business School and was the professor of industrial research. He is known as the founder of human relations movement. He is also known for his research, including famous Hawthorne's studies. He also pioneered the treatment of shell shock, that is post-traumatic stress disorder or PTSD. Productivity refers to how much each worker produces per hour, per day, per week, etc., and his work in Hawthorne was basically for productivity. He observed the Hawthorne's effect while assessing the effects of working conditions from 1927 to 1933. Mayo reported that the performance of workers improved when management showed concern for their problems. In fact, when that concern was evident, their productivity increased regardless of their working condition. Mayo research and experiments marked a sea change in thinking about productivity and work. Mayo is considered as father of human resource management. Hawthorne's experiment, we can take four parts out of it. The first part is illumination experiment, which started from 1924 to 27. These experiments were performed to find out the effect of different levels of illumination, that is lighting, on productivity of labor. The brightness of light was increased and decreased to find out the effect on the productivity of the test group. Surprisingly, after a period of time, when they increased the light, the production increased, but when they decreased the light, the productivity increased further, which was a surprising fact. And it was concluded in this particular experiment that the factors other than light were also important. The second part of the experiment was relay assembly test room study, which started and lasted for 2 years, from 1927 to 1929. These were two tests where two small groups of six female telephone relay assemblers were selected. Each group was kept in separate rooms. From time to time, changes were made in working hours, rest periods, lunch breaks, etc. And they tried to see whether it has got its effect on the productivity and the overall effectiveness of the workers. And they were also allowed to choose their own rest periods and to give their own suggestions. Output increase in both the control rooms. It was concluded that the social relationship among workers, participation in decision making, etc., had a great effect on productivity than working conditions. The Hawthorne's experiments part 3 was known as mass interview program. It ended within 2 years, started in the year 1928 and ended on 1930. There approximately 20,000 workers were interviewed over a period of 3 years to find out reasons for increased productivity. It was concluded that productivity can be increased if workers were allowed to talk freely about matters that are important to them. During interviews, it was discovered that the workers' behavior was being influenced by group behavior. However, this conclusion was not satisfactory, and therefore researchers decided to conduct another series of experiments. As such, the detailed study of a shop situation was started to find out the behavior of workers in small groups. In the part 4 of the experiment, which is also known as bank wiring observation room experiment, it lasted for almost 6 months. A group of 14 male workers in the bank wiring room were placed under observation for 6 months. A worker's pay depend on the performance of the whole group as a whole. The researchers thought that the efficient workers would put pressure on the less efficient workers to complete the work. Therefore, they made the group of the efficient, less efficient and average worker as one group. However, it was found that the group established its own norms, its own standard of output, and the social pressure was used to achieve the standards of the output. Now we will see the conclusions derived from the Hawthorne's studies. They were as follows. The social and psychological factors are responsible for workers' productivity and job satisfaction. Only good physical working conditions are not enough to increase productivity. It was also seen that the informal relations among workers influence the workers' behavior and performance more than the formal relations in the organization. The employees will perform better if they are allowed to participate in decision making affecting their interests. Employees will also work more efficiently when they believe that the management is interested in their welfare. When the employees are treated with respect and dignity, their performance will increase. Financial incentive alone cannot increase the performance. Social and psychological needs must also be satisfied in order to increase the productivity. Good communication between the supervisors or superiors and the subordinates can improve the relations and the productivity of the subordinates. And lastly, it was seen that special attention and freedom to express their views will improve the performance of the workers. Thorne's experiment is considered to be one of the great breakthroughs of experiments because it established the human relations foundation, which was not before. However, it was criticized on several grounds. We will see the grounds on which they were criticized. The first was it lacks validity. They said the criticizers said that the Hawthorne's experiment were conducted under control situations, which means that people knew that they are being observed. And if people know that they are being observed, there is always a chance that they will try to improve their performance at the time of experiments. Number two, more importance was given to the human aspects. The criticizers always say that too much importance was given to the human aspect. Human aspect alone cannot improve production. Production also depends on technological and other factors. The third most important point, which is put as a critic or by the critic, is more emphasis is given on the group decision making. The experiments place too much emphasis on group decision making. In real situation, individual decision making cannot be totally neglected, especially when quick decisions are required and there is no time to consult others. And the last of the most important critique is over importance to freedom of workers. The Hawthorne's experiment gives a lot of importance to freedom of the workers. It does not give importance to the constructive role of the supervisors. In reality, too much freedom to the workers can lower down their performance or productivity.